So in the previous lecture, we have studied about isolated points. We have also defined what is closure of the set, and we have defined or we have considered a lot of examples where whenever certain set A is given, what is the closure of that set. Now we will do a very important theorem about the closure of the set. The statement is like this. Let x, d be a metric space and A be subset of x. Then first thing is A bar is closed set. A bar is closed set. Secondly, A is closed if and only if A is equal to A bar. Third is A bar is smallest closed set of X containing A. And fourth statement is A bar is the intersection of all closed subsets of X containing A. This is analogous to the theorem that we have proved in case of interior of the set. So now proof. Here, first thing is we have to prove, in first part we have to prove A1 is closed set. Now how will you do this? A bar is closed set. I have to prove any set whenever I want to prove closed. There are two ways. One is its complement is open, and second is you prove that it contains all its limiting points. Okay, so we will use the second technique, proof of first part. So XD is a metric space that is common. A is subset of X that is given. To prove that, A bar is closed set. A bar is closed set. So what you do is let X be limit point of A bar. X be limit point of A bar. What do you mean by X is limit point of A bar? You apply your definition of limit point. X is limit point of A bar. So what we can say, if you take any epsilon neighborhood around X, it contains a point of A bar other than X. So in short, what I can say is, for any epsilon greater than 0, so here we will say, for given epsilon greater than 0, right, there exists Y belonging to A bar. There exists Y belonging to A bar such that Y belongs to epsilon neighborhood around X. What do you mean by Y belongs to epsilon neighborhood around X? Distance between Y and X is less than epsilon. So instead of writing all that Y belongs to epsilon neighborhood around X, we will say such that DXY is less than epsilon. Is it right? So what is that Y? Y belongs to A bar. So further, as Y belongs to A bar, what do you mean by Y belongs to A bar? Either Y belongs to, see, A bar is what? It is A union limit points of A. So So whenever y belongs to a union limit point of a, there are two possibilities. Either y belongs to a or y is limit point of a. So further, as y belongs to a bar is a union a dash, right? A bar is a union a dash. So it implies y belongs to a or y belongs to a dash. It means y belongs to a or y is limit point of a. Y belongs to A or Y is limit point of A. So if Y is limit point of A, what we can say? Same story. Y is limit point of A, if you take any say epsilon neighborhood, any epsilon you take, and you take epsilon neighborhood around Y, then it will contain point of A other than Y. Suppose that point is Z. And if you, instead of taking epsilon, and if I take epsilon by 2, any epsilon value I can take. So y is limit point of A. So there exists z belonging to A such that there exists z belonging to A such that what? Dyz is less than epsilon by 2. Have you understood? Here also, for given epsilon greater than 0, there exists y belonging to a bar such that dxy I can take less than epsilon by 2. So for further adjustments, here also instead of epsilon we take epsilon by 2. Okay, see, now again we will repeat, a bar is a closed set we have to prove. So I have taken limit point of a bar and my aim is to show x belongs to a bar. X is any arbitrary limit point we have taken, and if I can show that it belongs to a bar, we are through. It means every limit point will be in the A bar. Every limit point of A bar is in A bar. So A bar is closed. Okay. So whenever you say that x is limit point of A bar, you know for every epsilon greater than 0, if you take epsilon by 2 open sphere around x, it will contain point of A bar other than x. So this y we have taken. Y belongs to A bar. Dxy less than epsilon by 2. But when you say y belongs to A bar, y is either in A or in A dash. If y is in A dash, y is limit point of A. So again, under the definition of limit point to y. And we can say that there will be a point Z, but that point Z is of A. Correct? Because Y is limit point of A. So that Z will be from A, such that distance between Y and Z, because Z will be in the epsilon by 2 neighborhood around Y. And so distance between Y and Z is less than epsilon by 2. So now you consider distance between X and Z. Use Crandall inequality. Use Crandall inequality. So this will be what? This will be less than or equal to distance between x, y and plus distance between y, z. Now what is distance between x, y? Less than epsilon by 2. You can see here, less than epsilon by 2. So it is less than epsilon by 2 plus epsilon by 2. Distance between y and z. So it is epsilon. What does this mean? If you take distance, when you say distance between x and z is less than epsilon, what it means? X lies where? Can you conclude from this x belongs to a bar? Think about it. See, what is x? Distance between x and z is less than epsilon. So if I take epsilon neighborhood around x, it contains z, where z is the point of A. What do you mean by this? When you write this, what is our conclusion? X is limit point of A, because z is in A. So what we have said there is epsilon neighborhood around x contains a point of A other than x. And so this implies, this implies x is limit point of A. Now when x is limit point of A, this implies x belongs to A dash. But then this implies x belongs to A union A dash. A union A dash is a bar. So we have to, so x belongs to A bar. So whenever you have started with x is a limit point of A bar, it belongs to A bar. And so we have proved that A bar is a closed set. because it condemns all its limit points. This is rather involved force. You have to deliberately take epsilon by 2 here. Y belongs to A bar. A bar means A union A dash. So Y belongs to A or Y belongs to A dash. If Y belongs to A dash, it means Y is the limit point of A. Y is the limit point of A means what? There is Z belonging to A such that DYZ is S. Because what is the definition of Y? What do you mean by Y is the limit point of A? If you take any epsilon and if you take epsilon neighborhood of Y, it will contain point of A other than Y. So that point we have taken Z. And so distance between Y and Z will be less than epsilon. So that statement is answered. And now you use standard equivalent. DAZ, it becomes less than epsilon. And what does it mean? Epsilon neighborhood of X contains a point Z which is in it. And so it means what? X is the limit point of A. So X belongs to A dash. And A union A dash is A bar. So X belongs to A bar. So whatever is in A dash will belong to A union A dash. So it is A bar. So X belongs to A bar. So all these things finally conclude that X, we have started with X is the limit point of A bar and you proved it belongs to A bar. So it means every limit point of A bar is point of A bar. And so A bar is closed. See the way we argue. A bar is a closed set. I hope you understood what we are saying here. Now second part. Can anyone do? This is very simple. A is closed if and only if A is A bar. In first part, see whenever we are doing results like this, patterns now you must understand. Many times you will prove results like this. In that always it is done that whatever is proved in first part is used in second part. Whatever is proved in first two parts is used in third part. This pattern now you must understand, not rules. So how to use this? Can you use first part to prove second part? See, suppose you are given. So suppose A is equal to A bar. I have to prove if and only if statement. So I will start with A is equal to A bar. Right? By one, what we have proved in one? A bar is closed. And A bar is equal to A, so A is closed. So this implies A is closed. Done. What about converse part? Converse part. What is to be proved? You are given A is closed and you have to prove A is equal to A bar. A is equal to A bar is assumed and then A is closed is proved. Now conversely, see these are very simple results if you have your basic ideas here. Conversely, what is given? What is given? A is closed. So given A is closed. To prove that A is equal to A bar. So whenever I want to prove A is equal to A bar, what is the way? When two sets are equal, if I want to prove, I must prove A is subset of A bar and A bar is subset of A. So how to do that? You are given A is closed. In first part, you prove A bar is closed set. And now I want to prove A bar is equal to A. This is what I have to prove. Know that A is equal to A. So how to do this? Out of that, A is subset of A bar directly follows. A is subset of A bar, obvious. And you want to prove A bar is subset of A. Now that is also obvious because A bar is what? A union A dash. A bar is, this is the definition of A bar, A union A dash. And you are given here A is closed. What do you mean by A is closed? In one result we have told, set is closed if and only if it contains all its limit points. So that you can use now. A is closed. So as A is closed, this is one. Okay. Now as A is closed, A is closed. A dash is subset of A. You have proved this. What is A dash? Set of all limit points. And when set is closed, it contains all its limit points. So if you consider a set of all limit points of the set A, which is A dash, it is subset of A. Now when A dash is subset of A, what is A dash union? It is in. Because A dash is subset of A, you can see this is your A, this is your OK, this is A, this is A dash is subset of A. What is the union? A. That means it is true. Okay. So A bar is a union A dash and it will be A dash union A is A. So A bar is subset of A. This is A2 and from 1 and 2, A is equal to A. Okay. So whenever set is closed, it contains all its limit points. This result which we have already proved, we are using here effectively. So this is the trend in all these proofs. We must be very strong in the knowledge of previous results. Then you can apply them in proving the further results. So second part is done. Now what is to be proved in third part? A bar is the smallest closed subset of X containing B. Now what is the technique of proving it is smallest? See, you have to prove A bar is the smallest closed subset of X containing A. So what you do is you take some closed subset of X containing A. You take B suppose. B is the subset of X containing A. And you prove A bar is subset of that. Then we are proved. Then A bar will be smallest. See, these are the patterns of the proofs. If I want to prove certain thing is the largest, then you take some subset satisfying that property and show that this subset is subset of that. And here I have to prove smallest. So what can be done? So as usual, third part now. What is given here is to prove that A bar is smallest closed subset of X containing A. So start with B, let B be what? Closed subset of X containing A. To prove that what? If I want to prove A bar is the smallest, what I should prove? To prove that A bar is subset of B. If I have to do this, then we are true. So, how to prove this is subset of that? You start with the element of this and prove that it is here. So, let X belongs to A bar. Let X belongs to A bar. What do you mean by X belongs to A bar? This implies X belongs to A union A dash. This means it implies X belongs to A or X belongs to A dash. Now here we have taken B is a closed subset of X containing A. That means A is subset of B. And if X belongs to A, X will belong to B. Obvious. So if X belongs to A, it implies what? X belongs to B. Have you understood? B is a closed subset of X containing A. What this sentence tells you? A is subset of B. So whatever is in A is in B. So if X belongs to A, X must be in B. Okay? So in this case, when X belongs to A bar, X belongs to B is good. Now other way around, if X belongs to A dash, Now what to prove? X belongs to B. This is also obvious. What do you mean by x belongs to A'? This implies x is limit point of A. Is it right? X is limit point of A. What do you mean by x is limit point of A? For each epsilon greater than 0, for each epsilon greater than 0, Sx epsilon is Sx epsilon contains point of what? A other than x. Okay? Now what? For each epsilon greater than 0, Sx epsilon contains point of A other than x. But also you know, what do you know? B is closed subset of x containing A. So as A is subset of B, if that open epsilon neighborhood around X contains point of A, it will also contain point of B. Because A is subset of B. So whatever is in A is also in B. So contains point of A other than X. As A is subset of B, Sx epsilon will contain what? Point of B other than x, right? Now when x contains point of B other than x, what it means? X is what it will mean? See here, what we have proved is, if you take any epsilon greater than 0, for each epsilon greater than 0, Sx epsilon will contain point of B other than x. It means what? X is limit point of B. Obvious, right? So this means x is limit point of B. That means x belongs to B dash. As x is limit point of B. So, now when x belongs to B dash, x belongs to B union B dash. Right? But what is B union B dash? This is B bar. So x belongs to B bar. What I want to do? Is it done? If bar is the smallest subset of x containing A, so let B be the closed subset of we want to do x belongs to I think we have to here what we are proving, we want to actually prove A bar is subset of B. Right, we want to prove A bar is subset of B. Is it follows? For each epsilon greater than 0, Sx epsilon contains point of A other than x. Can we justify this statement? Sx epsilon contains point of x other than x, but as A is subset of B, Sx epsilon contains point of B other than x. That is true. Is it right? So x belongs to B dash, we can say. And so as x belongs to B dash, x belongs to B union B dash, B bar. But we also know that B is a closed set. As B is closed set, B bar is equal to B. Already we have closed set is closed if and only B bar is equal to B. So x belongs to B bar is okay. But as B is closed subset, as B is closed subset of X, B is equal to B bar. And so, when you say x belongs to B bar, so x belongs to B bar implies what? X belongs to B. Now we have proved. So we have started with x belongs to A bar and we proved x belongs to B. Okay, so here what now we can conclude? This implies. So what we have proved in all this development that we have done? we all know that x belongs to V bar. What actually we wanted to do? X belongs to A bar. Implied x belongs to B. That was good. So if x belongs to A bar, if x belongs to A bar, it implies x belongs to B. And so what happens? A bar is subset of B. So B was what? Any closed set containing A. And here we have proved that A bar is subset of B. So A bar is what? Smallest closed subset containing B. That is good. Now the last part is that A bar is the intersection of all closed subsets. For B. I think that is also obvious, because what we do is, you take closed subsets. Here the statement is this: A bar is intersection of all closed subsets of X containing B. So what you do is consider the collection of all the closed subsets of X containing B and take their intersection. We know that arbitrary intersection of closed sets is closed. Right? Arbitrary union of open sets is open, but in case of intersection and closed sets, the result is this. So that intersection will be also closed set. So here what we can say, let M is equal to the set, or we will say M is equal to intersection of B subset of X, where B is closed subset, B is closed subset of X, and B contains A, containing A. What is the meaning of this? M is arbitrary intersection of closed subsets. So this implies, because how many closed subsets are there, that we do not know. So M is arbitrary intersection of what? Of closed subsets of X. Containing B. So that implies M is closed. M is closed. Not only it is closed, but it is smallest closed. So M is smallest closed subset of what? Subset of X. Containing A. But in the previous result, what we have proved? A bar is the smallest closed subset of X containing A. So this M must be A bar. So M is equal to A bar by third part. By three. And so that implies what? It implies one thing, that A bar is the intersection of all closed subsets of X containing A. So this is a four-part theorem about closure of the set, and this is exactly analogous to the theorem about interior in case of open sets. Now the next result, it's a, what we can say, seventh part theorem. I give this as an exercise to you. I will not prove, but I will give hints what to do. So let X T be the metric space, and A and B be the subsets of X. A and B, two subsets of X. Then first result is phi bar is equal to phi. Closure of empty set is empty set. Secondly, closure of X is equal to X. Then if you consider third result, it is what we have to do is a bar. Bar is equal to a bar. Then fourth part is if A is subset of B, it implies A bar is subset of B bar. Then fifth part is A union B bar is equal to A bar union B bar. Sixth is A intersection B bar is subset of A bar intersection B bar. And finally, seventh part is A dash. What is A dash? Derived set of A, set of all limit points. A dash is equal to A bar dash. This is seven parts here. How to prove this? I will just give hints. You try this as an exercise. Empty bar is empty. Now you know that in any metric space, the whole set X is open also, closed also. And empty set is also both open and closed. So we will use this part that empty set is a closed subset of X. And we have in previous result we have done A is closed if and only if A is equal to A1. So when the set is closed, its closure is same as that set. You know empty set is closed. So what will be closure of empty set? Empty. So that is done. First part is done. What about second part? Same story. Whole metric space is both open and closed. So we will use the fact that X is closed. And now you know the result that A is closed, A is equal to A1. So when X is closed, X bar is equal to X. Here also same story, A bar is closed set, in previous result we have proved, A bar is a closed set. And whenever set is closed, its closure is equal to itself. See here, A bar is what? A bar is closed set. A bar is closed set, already we have proved. And also we know that when set is closed, we have this result. If, suppose, A is closed set, then A is equal to A1. Now apply this result to A bar. A bar is closed set. So what is A bar bar? See how we are using previously proved results. So I will always suggest that you make the list of previously proved results only. Don't write their proofs. Results only you don't have. Because all those results are very important and you are always using those results to develop further results. Now what about this? A is subset of B implies A bar is subset of B bar. So here you are given A is subset of B and you want to prove A bar is subset of B bar. So where you will start your proof? Where you will start your proof? You have to prove A bar is subset of B bar. See, you should start me here. This is given. This is not to be proved. In the proof somewhere you will use A is subset of B. So if you start proving the result at a proper place, then results are very simple. So see, whenever, I will not write detailed proof, but it is something like this. I want to prove A bar is subset of B bar. So to prove that A bar is subset of B bar, what is given here? A is subset of B. Always whenever you are writing proof, first try to know what is given to you. Then start what is to be proved. There you should have this knowledge that whenever I want to prove this, what I have to do. And how to use this? How to use this given thing in this proof? One thing you remember in mathematical statements, nothing is given which is not used in the proof. So if anyone claims that you have proved A bar is subset of B bar without using A is subset of B, 100% proof is wrong. You have to use this because that is unnecessarily nothing is given in mathematical statements. Preciseness is the main issue in mathematics. So precise, it is always precise. So if it is given, you have to use it somewhere. Okay, so what I have to prove? A bar is subset of B. How to prove this? I should start with some element of A bar and show that it is given. So where I can start? Let x belongs to V1. What is to be proved? X belongs to V1. Now if x belongs to A1, what does it mean? What is A1? A union A dash. So when you say x belongs to A1, x belongs to A or x belongs to A dash. But if x belongs to A, it implies x belongs to B. Why? Because A is subset of B. See here we have used A is subset of B. Whenever something is in A, it must be in B because A is subset of B. So x belongs to B. Now, if x belongs to A dash, then what? If x belongs to A dash, then what? A is the limit point of it. X is limit point of that is what? If I take any epsilon open sphere around x, it contains point of A other than x. But if it contains point of A other than x, it also contains point of B because A is subset of B. So all the points in A are also subsets of B. So I can treat for my convenience all the points as the points of B. So when x belongs to A dash, what I will say? X is limit point of A. This is an exercise I will not write anything. X is limit point of A, that is every epsilon when you check open sphere around x with radius epsilon will contain point of A other than x. But as A is subset of A, all those points which are in A can be considered as a point of B because A is subset of A. And so it means what? Every epsilon neighborhood around x contains point of B other than x. And what does that mean? X belongs to B dash. Okay, so now either x belongs to B or x belongs to B dash. So x belongs to B union B dash. So what is B union B dash? B bar. So x belongs to B bar. So when you started with x belongs to A bar, you proved x belongs to B bar. So A bar is subset of B bar. So see how effectively here also whenever we started with x belongs to B dash and we proved x belongs to B dash, we have used A subset. Because all the points which are in epsilon neighborhood of x of A are also points of B. If they are points of B, you cannot say that they are points of A. Because whenever you say A is subset of B, this is A suppose, this is B, all the points of B are not in A, but all the points of A are in B. So that thing we have used. And what does this imply? This result is proved. A is subset of B implies A bar is subset of B. We should start writing the rules, then it is not difficult. Now this A bar, A union B bar is A bar union B bar. This I have to prove. Equality I have to prove. So I have to know the method. I must know the method. I should prove this is subset of this and then prove this is subset of this. Now I think this is not difficult because one thing is simple, that fifth part. So here you want to do what? A union B bar is equal to A bar union B. One part is obvious. A is subset of A union B. Right? A is always subset of A union B. And you have put here, if A is subset of B, A bar is subset of B bar. So when A is subset of A union B, what does this imply? A bar is subset of A union B bar. Also B is subset of A union B. What does this imply? B bar is subset of A union B bar. Now this is also subset, this is also subset of same set. So union of this also subset of that. So we proved A bar union B bar is subset of A union B bar. But this is suppose result A. Proof is not over here. This is only one part proof. B bar union B bar is subset of A union B bar. Now other way around here. Other way around is what? To prove that now A union B bar is subset of A bar union B. Try to prove this. How to do? What is the technique? You have to start with some element of A bar union B bar. Sorry, A union B bar, and prove that it is in A bar union B bar. So you start with X, try to develop this proof. X belongs to A union B bar. What does it mean? X belongs to A bar. A union B or derived set of A union B. Or in some cases what is done is whenever you say X belongs to A bar, many in many literature, many basis we will find this argument. When x belongs to a bar, then consider x is the limit point of u. So here also we can use that if x belongs to a union v bar, x is limit point of a union v. What do you mean by x is limit point of a union v? If you take any epsilon open sphere around x, then it will contain at least one point of x other than a union, other than at least one point of a union b other than x. But when it is a point of a union b other than x, you can say it is a point of either a or point of b. So if it implies x belongs to a bar or x belongs to b bar, and so x belongs to a bar union. Like this argument can be made. So try to write these things in a proper way. And you are writing mathematical proofs, so there should be a flow in that. What is written first, then what is the second statement? How you came to second statement from first statement? Some reasoning you have to give. So that is, practice will make you perfect in that writing skills. And now this part. This part is also obvious. A intersection B bar is subset of A bar intersection B bar. When you want to do that, you have to observe this. A intersection B is subset of A. Also, A intersection B is subset of B. So, by using this result, if A is subset of B, A bar is subset of B bar, what does this imply? This implies A intersection B bar is subset of B bar. Here, what does this imply? A intersection B bar is subset of B bar. So, this set is subset of A bar also, subset of B bar also. So, it is in both. It is in both means it is in its intersection. And so, what you can say? A bar. A intersection B bar is what? Subset of A bar intersection B. So we are, so I think nearly I have proved all the questions, but not in a proper way. You can write it. What about this? I leave this as entirely to you. But what will be the hint here? What is A dash? Derived set of. So here we are saying that if you consider limit points of A, they are same as limit points of A bar. This statement means limit points of A are same as limit points of A. For example, this is not the proof, it is just an example. You try to do this. See, if I consider capital A, your usual metric space R, comma D, you check. D is usual metric. And you take A as say open interval AB. What are the limit points of this? A and B are also limit points. So, limit points of this are A dash is what? Here, closed interval AB. A dash is closed interval AB. What is A bar here? A bar means what? A bar is itself closed interval AB. A bar means what? It is A union limit points. Now what are the limit points of this set? Oh, closed interval AB is limit points. So when you check union, you get closed interval AB. Now A bar is closed interval AB. So A bar is a closed set. And you know whenever set is closed, it contains all its limit points. A bar dash. What are the limit points of this? A bar dash. It is nothing but closed interval AB. So see, A dash is same as A bar dash. This is not a proof, this is just an example. But you have to prove like this. Now these two sets are equal. Whenever you want to prove two sets are equal, you prove this is subset of this and then this is subset of left hand side. So try to write. So you will start with x belongs to a dash. It means what? X is limit point of a. Apply the definition of limit point of a. And you have to prove it is limit point of a bar. See how to do that. I leave it with the exercise. So I am talking about many times, I am talking about the patterns of mathematical proofs. As far as whatever you have to study, not many times you will prove results like this, having four parts. Having already you have learned two results about in four parts. One is about interior of the city. Second is about closure of the set. So they were containing four parts. Now this is the seventh part here. Now what you have observed in this three theorems is whenever I am cooling, I cannot go to directly any part. Directly you cannot go to any part. Because if I want to prove this result, I have to use this in this proof of this. So I must go line by line. Sequentially you have to do this, because all the previous results you are using in cooling for the result. Now, here one example we will consider and then conclude this lecture. See, the example is this. In case of this particular see, if you consider six part in this. In six part, what we have done is, first we will write down the remark, then you will justify it. In six part, what you have done is, A intersection B bar is subset of A bar intersection B. So it is proper subset, it is never equal. Right? So we can say remark is, A intersection B bar is not equal to A bar intersection B. It is just subset, proper subset. It's not equal. How to prove this? As an example, now this example we will consider. What you do is, you consider usual metric R, T. And let you consider the set A as, say, open interval 0, 1. Open interval 0, 1. And B as open interval 1, 2. B is open interval 1, 2. These are the two sets. Now, what is A bar? A bar is closed interval 0, 1. B bar is closed interval 1, 2. You always know, if you take open interval AB, its closure is closed interval AB. So here A bar is open interval, A is open interval 0, 1, B is open interval 1, 2. So A bar is this, B bar is this. Now what is the left hand side? A bar, A intersection B bar. What is A intersection B? This is your A, this is B. What is that intersection? Nothing is common. So A intersection B is empty. And A intersection B is empty. So what is this left hand side? A intersection B bar. A intersection B bar. A intersection B bar is empty bar. And you have proved that is that empty bar is empty. Right? Now what about second part? Right hand side. A bar intersection B bar. What is A bar? Close interval 0, 1. What is B bar? Closed interval 1, 2. So what is A bar? Intersection B bar. It is closed interval 0, 1. Intersection closed interval 1, 2. What is the intersection? Singleton 1. Singleton 1 is common to both. So in short, your left hand side, A intersection B bar was empty. But A bar intersection B bar is singleton. So they are not equal. This is the main remark. A intersection B bar. See here, A intersection B bar is empty set and A bar intersection B bar is singleton. Empty set is always subset of any set. So this is subset, proper subset. Equality is not expected here. So this is the one thing that we have to observe. In all these results, why it is? Why this is subset? Why this is not equal to? Always you must have this question in your mind. Here we have proved equality, here we have not proved equality. So as it is not equality proved, you must be able to produce one example where A intersection B bar and A bar intersection B bar are not equal. And this is the example which justifies what you have mentioned here. So all such things we have to always keep in mind. You must be able to support anything that you write. If you have written subset, it is subset. Equality is not allowed. So anyone will say, why you have not written equality there?
You produce this example. Equality never works.
Here, this is very obvious. Logically, you have proved a union, vibhag, vibhag, union, vibhag. Here also, logically, we have proved. But here, equality we have not written. Here, equality was there. Here, equality is not written. Why? This is an example. So, this is important in all the mathematical books. Now, one or two exercises I will give you. Check one. What you do is, in the matrix space SD, this is an exercise to you. First exercise. Suppose XD is the matrix space. Okay. And you prove that if you consider open sphere SXR, then its closure is closed sphere SXR. This is equivalent to open interval when you take its closure is closed interval. But this is not open interval. This is any matrix space. Open interval, etc. All those things come whenever you take real line as your matrix space. Yeah, in general. And the last proof that I would like you to do is this. Suppose XD is a matrix space. And A is subset of X. Then prove that X minus A closure of X minus A is equal to X minus A interior. X minus A interior. First, what you do is when you want to prove this result, and if you cannot directly understand what is happening, you take one example. You take particularly suppose R is a matrix space, we usually take A as some subset, say over interval 1, 2, and then try to first see, is it whether this is right? You can calculate A interior, you can calculate X minus A bar, and then see whether this is equal. And then you can get some clue which will be by which you can be able to prove actually. This is the method. Whenever I cannot directly prove, first you go for a numeric example. First you go for a concrete example, which is about this. You can see how these two things are equal. It may be possible that that example will give you clue to prove the general result. Okay, so we have done all these two important results in this lecture.